This is about periodic table or periodic classification of elements. Now today I will talk about trends in the modern periodic table. Trends in the modern periodic table. Now the physical and chemical properties of an element mainly depends upon its outermost electronic configuration. Configuration means position, means the physical and the chemical properties depend, okay, how many electrons are in the outer shell. Okay, so since the outer electronic configuration changes as you go from left to right in the period, therefore within the same period elements show a gradation or variation. Gradation means variation, okay, both in their physical and chemical properties. On the other hand, within a group, the elements have the same outer electronic configuration, means they do have the same number of electrons in the outermost shell. Therefore, their chemical properties are similar, but their physical properties show a regular gradation as we move down the group from top to bottom due to a corresponding increase in number of filled inner cells. Okay, so the physical and the chemical properties of the elements, they depend upon the number of electrons present in the outermost shell, and we call this valence shell. Okay, when you move from left to right in a period, the number of electrons goes on increasing, and therefore the physical and the chemical properties also goes on changing it is. Okay, but in a group from top to bottom, the number of electrons in the outermost is same. Therefore, their physical properties are same. Their chemical properties are same, but their physical properties are different. Right? Now, so these properties means from left to right or top to bottom. These properties which show a regular gradation or variation on moving from top to bottom within the same group or from left to right along a period are called atomic properties. Okay, so atomic properties means the change in the properties of atom of an element when moving from top to bottom in a group and from left to right in a period. So that is called atomic property. For example, okay, valency, atomic size, metallic, non-metallic character, and chemical reactivity. So these are the some of the atomic properties. So now let us see how these properties varies in a period and in a group. Now first let us consider this valency. So valency is defined as the combination capacity of an element. The combining capacity of an element it depends upon the number of valence electrons. Valence electrons means in the outermost electrons. Electronic electrons present in the outermost shell of an atom are known as valence electrons. So, now variations of valency in a period. Variations of valency in a period. On moving from left to right in a period, the number of valency electrons or valence electrons increases from 1 to 8. So, for example, let us consider the third period. So third period contains elements like sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine and argon. So once again I am repeating here now: sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine and argon. You know, sodium has atomic number 11, magnesium has atomic number 12, aluminium has atomic number 13, silicon has atomic number 14, phosphorus has atomic number 15, sulfur has atomic number 16, chlorine has atomic number 17, and argon has 18. So, in case of sodium, the valence electron is 1, in magnesium it is 2, aluminium it is 3, silicon is 4, phosphorus is 5, sulfur is 6, and chlorine is having 7, and argon is having 8 electrons. So, these are the valence electrons. And therefore, the valency will be like this only. So, valency of sodium is 1, magnesium is 2, aluminium is 3, silicon is 4, and phosphorus is 3, sulfur is having 2, and this chlorine is having 1, and this argon is 0. So you know, valency from 1 to 3 and 4. So that is determined by the number of valence electrons. If it's more than 4, then we subtract the outermost electron present in an atom minus 8. It is here we subtract the valence electrons from 8. For example, suppose let us consider the phosphorus. Phosphorus has valence electrons 5. So 8 minus 5, it is 3. So 3 is the valency. For sulfur, the outermost electron is 6. So 8 minus 6, it is 2. So valency is 2. And chlorine has valency 8 minus 7, it is 1. And the last argon is having 8 minus 8, it is 0. So like this it is. So this was the valency in a period. Now, valency in a group. You know, all the elements in a group have similar outer electronic configuration. That is, they have same number of valence electrons. Therefore, the valency of all the elements in a group is fixed or is the same. It is. So there is no change of valency in a group. In a group, the valency of elements is same it is. Now let us talk about the atomic size. In an atom, if an atom is considered to be a sphere, this round sphere it is, you know, the atomic size is given by the radius of the sphere and is commonly known as atomic radius. So atomic radius is defined as the distance between the center of the nucleus and the outermost shell, which contains electrons, is an isolated atom. Okay, so the distance between the atomic radius is defined as the distance between the center of a nucleus and the outermost shell, which contains electrons, is an isolated atom. So, in a period, on moving from left to right in a period, the atomic radius decreases. The atomic radius decreases. The atomic radii of elements of the second and third periods. Okay, if you consider now, look here. So it increases from left to right in a period. It increases from left to right in a period. Okay, in a group, on moving from down, the atomic radius of elements increases gradually, and the atomic size increases down the group. This is because the new shells are being added as we go down the group. This increases the distance between the outermost electrons and the nucleus, so that the atomic size increases in spite of increasing nuclear charges. Now, metallic and non-metallic properties. The metallic properties in a period when you move from left to right decreases, and in a group the metallic properties from top to bottom it is increases. Okay, we have seen that in a group we have alkali metal, then earth alkaline metal, and then we come the chlorine and this argon, like this it is here in the third period. So the metallic, this chlorine and this argon are the other non-metals, and sodium and this potassium, this magnesium, so they are the metals. So they are in the left hand side in a period. So metallic characters decreases in a period from left to right, and metallic characters increases from top to bottom. Metallic characters increases from top to bottom. So this is all about trends in this periodic table about the atomic properties. Thank you.